another of Germany's rocket launching bases near the town of Brie in the Cherbourg Peninsula. Like other rocket installations pointing toward southern England, the completion of this base was interrupted by the Allied invasion. Previously, Allied bombings had delayed Nazi rocket launching plans for this area. During the year preceding the first robot attack, 13th June, Allies dropped 50,000 tons of bombs on launching ramps on the French coast and on robot laboratories in Germany. Radar on the English coast picks up the trail of a flying bomb headed toward London. Sudden silence indicates stoppage of the jet motor. The bomb goes into a dive. In the first 4 weeks of robot attacks, 2,752 persons were killed, 8,000 injured. Maritime fort at Cherbourg, where the entrenched Germans kept up a stubborn last-ditch resistance. After a naval barrage, Army P-47 planes batter the fort into submission to assure unmolested Allied harbor traffic and reconstruction work. Pictures of the air bombardment were made by naval personnel. Broadcasting a demand to surrender. The Nazis capitulate. Knocked out German emplacements facing the approaches to the harbor. The wrecked seaplane base west of the transatlantic dock showing the ramp in front of the base. The apron and hangars. Damage to industrial installations caused by the enemy before capitulating. Harbor traffic increases at Civitavecchia as port repairs continue. Landing craft dock at temporary piers to unload supplies for the Allied drive toward Leghorn, Florence, and Rimini. A German 280mm railroad gun moves out of the reconstructed Civitavecchia railway yard where it was captured. Nicknamed the Anzio Express by troops in the Anzio and Nettuno beachhead sector, where it was used by the Germans in timetable shellings, the gun weighs 210,000 kilograms, is 29.2 meters long, and is mounted on a special 24-wheel wagon. The airfield at Viterbo, wrecked by Allied aerial bombardment. Messerschmitts, Junkers, and other types of enemy aircraft caught on the ground. German aerial bombs. Wreckage also indicates concentrated Allied strafing. Repairing bomb craters in the Lake Bolsena area where the 1st French Division spearheads the attack on the Central Front. Nazi prisoners are transported to the rear. French and Angolese infantry push northward from Lake Bolsena for an attack on Torre Alfina. Torre Alfina. General Juin's drive gathers momentum as his forces reach the valley near Campiglia d'Orsia. Preparations for an artillery barrage. Long toms go into action, drawing fire from enemy self-propelled guns. In the east, artillery units lay down intensive barrages in the British 8th Army's drive up the Adriatic coast. Close deployment of guns indicates the lack of enemy air activity in this sector. On the western coast, 5th Army forces moving toward the port of Piombino reach Scansano. Pressing beyond Scansano. Antiquated German equipment on the outskirts of Monte Pascagli. Monte Pascagli after its capture by the 5th Army. Closing in through hilly terrain toward Piombino. Piombino, occupied by the 5th Army without resistance on 25th June, shows the effects of Allied precision bombing. Wrecked harbor and industrial installations designated as targets indicate the accuracy of the aerial bombardment. The unscathed residential districts. First Army Ordnance Collecting Point in the Cherbourg Peninsula. Damaged American tanks are repaired for further use at the front. German equipment of all types is brought to the depot for analysis, salvage, or possible use against the enemy. A captured gun carrier of Czech manufacture. Old German horse-drawn caisson. Action at Saint-Lô, easternmost point of the 55-mile American front, as American First Army pushes forward. On the eastern sector of the Normandy front, British troops moved toward German positions outside Caen. The 8th Battalion, Royal Scots, supported by tanks, drive toward one of the small villages flanking Caen. At times, less than 30 yards separated British and German tanks. First pictures of a new type British mortar. Rounding up Nazi prisoners as the British continue the encirclement of Caen.